and billions of stars and constellations, uncountable galaxies, emptiness of interstellar space, our planet and everything that is on it, each plant, tree or stone, everything is nothing but a part of one universal cosmic body of wisdom. This cosmic body of wisdom, a body of the Buddha, is embodied in the stupa.
Since time immemorial throughout all history, humanity have been striving for the realization of its highest ideal, drove by its deepest spiritual aspiration. No doubts, the Buddha, fully awakened one, embodies perfection of such image. The new era of human awakening began after him. However, we can trace back profound formation process of such human spirituality evolution since the prehistorical era, widely throughout Eurasian continent and Indian subcontinent. Our story begins by restoring the lost link of the birth of Bodhisattva ideal and ancient spirituality of prehistorical nomads culture. They were known as Skif, Skithai, Sakha and Shakya. Their habitats and movement covered the vast space of Central Eurasian steppes, stretching from the Black Sea, Ukraine, Russia and Kazakh steppes, Caucasus, the Pamir Plateau, Tian Shan, southern Siberian Altai, Mongol steppe and northern China up to Korean Peninsula. All those nomad spirituality share distinctive, unique commonality, cosmic mysticism, spiritual heroism of selfless and fearless love and wisdom, honoring such heroes in eternal oneness with heaven and earth. Such spirituality later shaped the core characters of Bodhisattva ideal. The Buddha was popularly called Shakyamuni, saint of Sakya, as descendant and inheritor of once the greatest spiritual federation of all ancient nomads, bounded by honorable brotherhood and heroism all over Eurasia continent. The Sangha, which the Buddha initiated to form, were founded on such principles of ancient Sakya federations. Now we come to the Sadharma Pandarika, final conclusion of Buddha Sakyamuni's all teachings, ultimate revelations of eternal truth, of all Buddha's supreme wisdom, sacred eternal oneness of whole universe and life in infinite cosmic divine power and our own beings. The great cosmic assembly of Sadharma Pandarika is unfolding, deepest secret mystery of cosmic miracles. Each of such miracles is nothing but parts of eternal cosmic mandala of whole oneness of the Buddha universe. Every epoch of this cosmic drama is played with great figures of bodhisattvas. Each bodhisattva has his own role, mission, power and character from his past into present and future. Dialogue between two great bodhisattvas, Manjushri and Maitreya, initiate the opening of this great cosmic drama. The Buddha, in his profound meditation, radiates innumerable rays of light between his eyebrow. Lights illuminates entire universe of all existence, indicating the wholesome enlightenment of all universe. Manjushri has been always a key witness to this cosmic enlightenment of all past Buddhas. He is the upholder of the sacred treasure of this cosmic wisdom of the previous Buddhas. After every past Buddha, he motivated and instructed all new bodhisattvas to attain this supreme wisdom. Thus, Manjushri became a teacher of all past Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. Now, Manjushri foretell Maitreya of the Buddha Sakyamuni's ultimate revelation of Saddharma Pundarika, utmost secret reality, of universal Buddhahood of all existence.
Saddharma Pundarika is all-embracing eternal cosmic mandala of all unified universe of one eternal Buddha Shakyamuni. Central figure of this cosmic miracle is the seven treasure stupa, which the Buddha Shakyamuni open and enter into after triple miraculous transformation of this Saha world into one unified pure land where all cosmic Buddhas of all universe assemble together in order to witness the greatest cosmic prophecy. The Buddha Shakyamuni, seated inside the stupa, proclaims over all cosmic assembly, "Who can maintain and inherit the Dhamma lineage of Saddharma Pundarika for all future in this Saha world after my Nirvana? Among all matters and missions, this is the most difficult task which require each one's profound and great vow. This is my earnest wish as much as all Buddhas. Since by keeping Saddharma Pundarika, you keep my body and of the Buddha of all times. All Buddhas approve such keeper with delight and joy." All of a sudden, the great earth broke, and from below, waves and waves of great numbers of bodhisattvas emerged, whom no one in the Pundarika assembly ever saw before. Bodhisattva Maitreya, central for this new revelation, represents all assemblies, astounds and doubts, and put forwards central question to the Buddha. Who are those great bodhisattvas? Maitreya and all assembly, knowing nothing about them, replying to the Maitreya's question, the Buddha revealed the core of the profoundest truth of what Saddharma Pundarika is all about.
After the Buddha, Buddha Dharma lineage spread from the west to eastwards from India for last 2500 years. As the Dharma spread eastwards, the lineage of the Saddharma Pundarika also evolved. The first evidence were the first 10 stupa built in India to honor the sacred remains of the Buddha Shakyamuni. He is the only one amongst all world religions founders, as we know today, who inherited most sacred cosmology of ancient nomads' spirituality to honor the deathless hero in the sacred burial mounds, which symbolize eternal unity of heaven and earth. The great King Ashoka expanded this sacred lineage by widely building stupas upon all lands where once ancient Saka union of spiritual heroism and brotherhood formed vast common spiritual space that unite northern India, Central Asia, West Asia, and the present West. Later, we witnessed the same territorial space flourish at Kushan Confederation, in which real Bodhisattva civilization unified all nations and peoples from Europe, Central Eurasia, India, and China by Great Silk Route. Impact of Swadharma Pundarika is evident in all archaeological remains all over Kushan territory, which include present India, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Central Asia, and Eastern Turkestan of present China. Kumar Jiva was instrumental as translating the Swadharma Pundarika into Chinese and bringing new insight and thought through his life work to Chinese Buddhism. His spiritual roots represent Indo-Kushan Central Asian Buddhism that were merged during Kushan era as truly pan-Eurasian Gandhara civilization. However, throughout all trace of Swadharma Pundarika eastwards, the climax of its cosmic prophecy had never been taken as its core message, till Nichiren of Japan in 13th century proclaimed the new era to come by forthcoming great bodhisattvas who were entrusted this most dramatic mission. It was Nichiren who first foresaw the second homecoming of true cosmic power of Swadharma Pundarika to India with the sacred mantra of Naму-Мё-Хо-Рэн-Гэ-Кё and reawakened the deepest and eternal relation between the Buddha and his true eternal children of India.
The time of awakening has come, first in Asia in 20th century, when humanity came across two symbolic historic events that will determine the future of the whole world. One was the first use of nuclear weapons over two Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The other was the first ever nation building in modern human history of new free India led by Mahatma Gandhi's non-violent freedom struggle. At the dawn of crucial turning point in history, profound encounter of two great souls of Asia took place in India at Gandhi's ashram of Wardha. Gandhi received one Japanese Buddhist monk whose life mission was solely to realize the central prophecy of Swadharma Pundarika, which no one for last 2500 years Buddhist history ever tried to dedicate one's life for such mission. In 15 minutes of their meeting, Mahatma, great soul of India, who saw India's sole mission as saving all humanity from violent path, realized the deepest meaning of the prophetic message of Swadharma Pundarika from this humble monk, whom Gandhi later began calling Fuji Guruji. On that fateful meeting, Gandhi adopted the sacred mantra of Naму-Мё-Хо-Рэн-Гэ-Кё and Dharmadram for his daily ashram prayer as opening prayer, and continued to do so throughout his tireless life for the National Liberation Movement and the New Social Awakening Movement. He broke his last fasting in his life with this sacred mantra for the unity and peace of India during the post-partition mass violence. Mahatma Gandhi's lifelong search for truth and his total dedication for new united India brought him the deepest reunion with the eternal true spirit of the Buddha. The greatest prophecy with all cosmic miracle of Swadharma Pundarika became heroic history making of new India and for the new era of global awakening. In today's India, you can see many new Vishwa Shanti stupas at major sacred cities of the Buddha as testimony to the return of the great spirit and cosmic unity of the Buddha during new nation building after independence of New India.
Stupas or peace pagodas in Europe appeared first in Great Britain in 1979 in the town of Milton Keynes and in 1985 in London. They resulted from the practice of Reverend Junsei Terasawa, a disciple of the most venerable Nichidatsu Fuji. In April 1988, Terasawa Shonin, as a messenger of peace, sets off down from Mount Kiyosumizan straight to New York to attend the third special Yuan session on disarmament. He was carrying with him the sacred relics of the Buddha, entrusted to him by the chief preceptor of the Toshodaiji Temple of Japan. Carrying sacred sharira in his hands, Terasawa Shonin visited several countries and historical sites of the world on his way to New York, among which there were the Tiananmen Square and Mountain Tai of China, Rangoon, the capital of Myanmar, the spot of Mahatma Gandhi's cremation and Mount Hithakuta of India, Jerusalem, Geneva, Berlin and Potsdam, where the G3 meeting was taking place in 1945. It was during that pilgrimage that Terasawa Shonin visited Moscow for the first time, where in the full moon of the lunar month Vaisak, he conducted a Buddhist ceremony right on the Red Square, accompanied by the future Khamba Lama of Buryatia. Right afterwards, Terasawa Shonin personally met with President Gorbachev and entrusted him with the sacred Buddha relics. In November 1989, the Berlin Wall was demolished. In autumn of the same year, Terasawa Shonin, together with Robbie Romero, an American Indian singer, produces and presents a video clip called Is It Too Late? The clip Is It Too Late? Was presented by Terasawa Shonin together with Richard Gere at a multi-thousand meeting in Washington. Later on, that clip was demonstrated at the UN General Assembly and broadcasted during the Global Forum, organized by the International Foundation for Survival. In December 1990, after the Iraqi invasion in Kuwait, Junsei Terasawa conducts the Rohachi Sesshin practice, 7-day long fasting and prayer for the purification of body and mind, in front of the United States Embassy in Baghdad, dedicating this practice to ceasing the bloodshed. 120 people from 18 countries of the world set up a peace camp on the Iraqi border. As a protest against economic blockade of Iraq, Terasawa Shonin assists in sending an array of humanitarian aid to the country and organizes a series of peace walks from Yerichon and Baghdad to Jerusalem. On the 21st of August 1991, the day of the Russian Velvet Revolution, Terasawa Shonin was praying on the barricade of the White House, beating that hammer drum. The sound of his drum and prayer was heard amid every public demonstration in Moscow. Junsei Terasawa decided to stay in the USSR for long. Under his leadership, the first sangha of the Bodhisattva of the Lotus Sutra appeared in Russia, and its activity became deeply interrelated with the process of profound transformation around the territory of the former Soviet Union as well as the entire Eurasia. From the very beginning, the Ukraine became the key place for the new Sannhas activity. Symbolically, it is in this land, connecting West and East, that today, on the threshold of the new millennium, marking the most dangerous and crucial moment in the history of humanity, a stupa, or kurgan of peace, is ready to appear as a universal symbol of great spiritual awakening and unanimity. A plot of land atop of a picturesque hill above Seversky Donets River has recently been allocated for the construction of a stupa that became possible thanks to self-denying endeavors of Reverend Roman 13th, a Ukrainian Buddhist monk who died of an incurable disease in 2008. His sincere practice, aspired at protecting the Buddha Dharma, was revealed during the Orange Revolution, when he, all alone, with his drum and prayer, stepped forward between the two opposing blocks with his call for unity. We are eager to fulfill Roman's wish and pledge by realizing his utmost dream, to erect a stupa in Pankovka.